Folks at home, good morning. It's Wednesday, November 7th, the day after Election Day. I hope you all voted, and I wish everybody would stop complaining. All right, folks at home. I don't know how to tell you guys this. I don't even call it an update. It's just, you guys are going to find out sooner or later, so I'm letting everybody know, because it's going to come out, and I'd rather be the one to tell you guys. So the truth is, I just really don't have anything to say because I turned the camera on and couldn't think of anything to say, and that's the truth. There you have it. You wanted to know, and now I told you, and I'm sorry. But seriously, folks, got some good news. Been working on a song for my viewers, my loyal fans. And the song is for you guys, and I'm going to sing it for you. I finished writing the song. We're going to do the music, hopefully this week, and put it together, and it goes like this. You're my folks at home. You're my folks at home. You're my folks at home. I can't hit that one. All the other notes, I'm perfect. That one high one, I just can't get it. You're my folks at home. You're my folks at home. Yeah, I know. I know what you're thinking. Oh, he could sing too? Yeah, I can. Wife's yelling at me because I'm not up with my celebrity details. Because she's sitting here watching some Regis and Kathy Lee show or something. But it's not Regis and it's not Kathy Lee, so I don't really get what's going on. But it's this blonde chick, Kelly Ripa, that's her name. And some black dude that I just found out his name is Mike. I think she said Strahan or Stratham or something. And I didn't know who he was. I don't watch TV, so I really don't know who he was. And I said, why is this dude dancing? Is he a dancer? She said, no, he's the host of the show. I said, well, I understand he's the host of the new Regis and Kathy Lay, but why is he dancing? And, oh, well, it's part of this, promoting this and that. I don't know what it is. But anyhow, folks at home, apparently the guy was a football player. I think that's what she said. Yeah, he was a football player. Remember my bumper that I showed you? So now my backup camera, my sensor, since I smashed my bumper, it just constantly beeps. So there's nothing I can do about that, folks at home. It's not my fault. So anyhow, yeah, I'm not up on the celebrity deals. I really don't care who's a celebrity. I don't know. I need to be more in tune to that stuff, I know. I'll get there. Don't worry, I'll get there, folks. Just like I'll get out of the parking spot eventually. Alright, here we go. Here we go, folks. Off for the day. I got a ton of running around to do. Just got done some more editing. And so, this is what I think I'm going to do. I think I'm going to put the daily vlogs up at nighttime. So I'll film all day, and then I'll put the vlogs up at night. I am definitely not a person that is motivated by money. I don't care. I do not care. I don't care how much you make, I don't care what kind of house you have, I don't care what kind of car you drive, I don't give a crap. I just want to be happy, that's all. And I'm dead serious. I mean, having money's nice, don't get me wrong, it's nice to have nice things, but I don't want a mansion and freaking Bentley and all that crap. That's crap, dude. Hi, can I have a skinny cinnamon latte, dolce, small?
A tall?
Yeah.
Sure,
anything else? Yeah, no, thanks. That's it. Thank you.
383.
Okay, thank you. I'm gonna go get my skinny Dolce Cabana thing. Folks at home, this is my daily vlog, and I'm at my favorite Starbucks here. I just want to pull up and say hi to some of the girls here because they're so cool, so nice. And they're like, you should do a prank here. And I'm like, I can't prank a place that already knows me. So I'll just put them in a vlog. Problem solved. So we're going to do that. We're gonna pull up. I'm going to do that. I'm going to pull up. And I'm going to do this. This is going to be really crazy. I'm going to do this. I'm going to come up to the drive-thru window at my Starbucks. And I'm going to say, how you doing? Because I have to sneeze. Because it's cold out here. It's 37. which isn't that cold. It's cold enough for a jacket, and I hate wearing jackets. I hate wearing coats. I just had to pull up and say hello to them. So since I can't do a prank, I could at least put you in a vlog, right?
Oh, yeah,
do you watch my vlogs?
Yes, okay. I watch your vlogs.
So tell everybody your name.
I'm Rachel, his favorite barista.
My favorite burrito? Barista?
Barista.
Barista, I'm kidding. All right, I'll see you tomorrow.
I'll see you tomorrow.
See you, Rachel.
Bye.
I can sing a couple songs for you if you want. I've been really trying, baby. Trying to hold back this feeling for so long. And if you feel like I feel, baby, come on. Ow, let's get it on. Ow! Alright, so I'm watching my new vlog that I just uploaded. And I'm about to head out the door, but I had to come home real quick to make sure that it uploaded. And just reading through some of the comments, and Alex, not sure how to pronounce the last name, H-A-J-N-A, Hanya, or I don't know. Sorry, Alex. But he said, Ed, honest question, why don't you move to L.A.? And I just wanted to address that. I don't know, just felt like addressing it. I guess some of you are, I don't know, some of you may know that I'm in L.A. once a month to film my videos. Maker Studios, I've told you guys, they produce my content. I fly to L.A. once a month, film a stockpile of videos, and then come home. It's very, very convenient and helpful for me. I get a professional camera crew, professional editors. It takes a lot of load off of me, and then I can come home and just be with my family and do other important stuff. There's a lot of reasons why I don't move to L.A. One of the reasons is I have a 16-year-old daughter that lives in New Jersey with her parents, with her mom and stepdad. And we see her very often, and, you know, we're very close. You know, obviously it's my daughter, so I don't want to be on the West Coast and her on the East Coast. That's one reason. The other reason is my wife has a lot of family out here. My wife has a big family out here. To be honest with you, like, I love the East Coast. I love the West Coast. And for those of you that go back and forth, there's things that you love about both of the coasts. But I just feel like my heart is on the East Coast. I was born and raised out here. My friends are out here. Actually, you know what? That's weird, because I actually probably have more friends on the West Coast than I do here on the East Coast. But I don't know. It's just home is where the heart is, I believe. So you want to know what's so exciting in my life? What's so exciting about my life? What's going on? I'll tell you what's going on. I'm headed to the bank. I gotta go to Sam Ash Music. I'm going there to look at a keyboard for my son for Christmas. What else? I gotta go to Party City for decorations for Jake. He's turning 10 this Saturday. We're having a birthday party for him, so I gotta get decorations for his party because I'm in charge of decorations. What else? I gotta go to the bookstore because I want to get some books for Jake for his birthday. You know, he's 10 years old, or he's gonna be 10. He's going through, you know, what every other, you know, kid his age is going through, which is an obsession with Minecraft and other video games. And I try to really curb his video game playing, because I just think that he should be doing other creative stuff. So I, last night, had him drawing and reading. He has to read every day. Whether he has school or not, Jake has to read every single day. 30 minutes, that's a requirement. At least 30 minutes. That's nothing. 30 minutes to read every day. I think every kid should. It just keeps your brain fresh. And it's not comic books. He's got to read something good. Well, I wouldn't say good. Good's just an opinion. He's got to read something that's potentially educational or has potential to just run on and run on like I'm doing. Okay, so anyhow, yeah, Jake has to read 30 minutes a day. And I'm trying to get him into music because I was into music as a kid and I still am. You know, I had a keyboard, I had drum set, I had guitars growing up. And I want to get Jake into that too. He's not really into sports that much. He played soccer for like 3 years. But he's just not really into soccer anymore. He tried baseball, he tried karate, he's tried everything, and he's not really an athlete. And I'm not going to be one of those parents, well, And I'm not going to be the guy to push him into it. You know, if he doesn't want to do it, he doesn't want to do it. So that's the way I believe. That's the way I feel about that. So we will try to get him into some music. He's taking an acting class now, which he seems to like so far. And the reason I got him into the acting class is because he's kind of gotten real shy in the last couple years. For those of you that have seen his YouTube videos, he's not a shy kid. But for some reason, he just started getting really shy lately. So we're trying to get him to kind of open up a little bit. And I think with the acting class and some music lessons maybe, or a keyboard, I don't know. I'm going way overboard. See, here's, last night I think I had another, you know, I don't know. I'm trying to see if he can find something else that he's passionate about besides playing video games. I hate this weather. That's the one thing, getting back to moving to California, dude, I hate this weather, man. I hate cold weather. I know Casey Levere likes cold weather. Every time Casey Levere comes out here, man, he loves it. Oh, he loves it. Then why don't you move out here, dude? You like it so much, why don't you move out here? Why don't you walk to Gunnersville? All right, politics and religion. Two things I don't talk about normally. A lot of people are asking me on Twitter, on Facebook, on YouTube, who did you vote for? Who did you vote for? I don't tell people who I voted for. I think that that's personal. That's my personal business. I tell my wife and my mom, and that's about it. And I'll tell you why. I don't even tell my kids who I vote for, because I don't want to persuade them to vote for who I voted for. I want my kids to grow up and use their own mind and vote for who they want to vote for. But one of the reasons I don't make it, so this is why I don't tell people who I vote for. If I tell people that I voted for Romney, everybody that's a Barack diehard fan is gonna bash me. If I tell people I voted for Barack, everybody that's a diehard Romney fan is gonna bash me. You can't win. No matter who I tell you guys who I voted for, I'm just gonna hear a lot of crap that I don't feel like hearing, and I don't need to defend who I voted, why I voted for a particular candidate. I don't need to defend myself. I believe in what I believe in, and I voted for the person that I thought would make the best. I voted for the person that I thought would do the job the best. I'll leave it at that. You know, religion aside, you know, race aside, you know, everything aside, I vote for who I feel will do the best job for the country. And that's that. And no matter who wins, I support that person, you know. If it's not the person I wanted to win, I still support him because it's my country. I gotta be supportive. So what else? What else? Religion. Everybody always asks me, are you a Christian, are you Catholic, are you Muslim? Listen, I have no problem with saying I'm a Christian, I believe in the Bible. That's me. You don't like it? Bye. I don't really care. Listen, I have friends that are atheist, I have friends that are Muslim, I have friends that are everything. My best friend is Jewish. I don't care. I respect everybody. I don't care what religion you are. I just think that if we learned to respect everybody and their religions, the world would be a much better place. Think about all these wars and what they're centered on. It's pride. It's people and their religion and their power. You know, just respect everybody's religion and the world would be a much better place. And I know I probably sound like a hippie now. I don't really care. I mean, that's just the way I feel. I don't know. I don't go shake hands with somebody, say, hey, how you doing, and then find out they're Muslim and then say, oh, I can't be friends with you. That's not right. How could you do that? Like, how could you not be friends with somebody just because of their religion? That doesn't make sense. It's like not being friends with somebody because they're not a fan of the same team that you are. Like, I'm from Philly. I'm a diehard Eagles fan. Oh, you're a Dallas fan? Oh, can't be friends with you. It's just stupid. It's immature. It's ignorant. I think it's ignorance, really. See? It's snowing. Can you see that? Can you see the snow? It's landing all over me, my jacket and everything. You think I'm lying? You always think I'm trying to lie to you guys. It's snowing. Fighting at Walmart.
This is crazy.
Fighting at the Walmart. You're allowed to film anywhere you go. Don't matter. Fighting at the Walmart. Who cares? My job today is to expose the people that are fighting at Walmart. You hear that? Lady's fighting because she didn't get waited on fast enough. It's ridiculous. She's still going. Still fighting at the Walmart. Still fighting at the Walmart. Yelling at the Walmart. Yelling at the Walmart. Hear that? That's sleet. We call call that sleeting. It's sleet. Can you guys say that? It's called sleet. Can you say that? Say it. Sleet. That's called sleet. It's when, like, the rain turns into frozen sleet. Sleet. So I'm back home in my house. And look at this. Just look at it. Just look at it. Just look at this. Just look at this. Just look at it. Just look at it. Just look at this. Just look at it, would you? Hey, you want to do something annoying? I'll tell you something annoying. This is something, I've never done this in a video, but it's always fun to do to people. And I've been doing this for well over 10 years because a guy that I used to work with used to breathe like this. So whenever it's real quiet and I'm around somebody, I'll do it. And it really annoys, it's like my wife, for example, it really annoys my wife when I just go. So it's sort of like a snoring while you're awake. And this guy that I used to work with, he was very out of shape. He was kind of heavy, but he smoked like 3 packs of cigarettes a day, and he would breathe like that. And I do it all the time. I mean, you can ask anybody that knows me. I constantly do it. It's just, it became a habit, an annoying habit, but do that. Especially like if it's real quiet, and if you just like, let's say somebody's looking at their laptop, and you just kind of look over their shoulder. It's very annoying sound, so I don't know why I felt the need to tell you how to be annoying, but yeah. Oh, I almost forgot to tell you guys this, so check this out. Yeah, I know I constantly do this and then I don't have anything to tell you, but I just got an email from my agent. This is very exciting news. All right, so about 9 o'clock this morning, I go on my email and I check, and I have an email from my agent from last night that I overlooked, that I didn't see. And
he's a puppy. Yes, he is. He's a puppy. Him knocking on the door. He's a puppy. Who knocking?
Richard does not like to go outside, to say the least.
Hey, yo, puppy. Oh, yo, puppy and Jai.
Dad, you know it's snowing?
What?
Dad, you know it's snowing now?
What?
Dad, you know it's snowing now?
Yep. What? Oh, look at this. We have an Eskimo. I just want to address, not a big issue, nothing that I really care about, but I'm going to be serious about this. Tattoos. My sleeve, for in particular, my tattoo sleeve that's in progress. I'm gonna be mature about this. I'm not gonna be immature. So, but I'm seeing a lot of the comments that are like, "Why you got a tattoo? Well, you're gonna regret it." Okay, I'm just trying to be mature here, folks. That I understand that. All kidding aside, I understand that I might regret this someday. I'm 40 years old. I think I know a little bit about myself by now. But let's rewind a little bit. I got my first tattoo when I was 16 years old. I actually got a misfit skull right there on my arm, and it was about that big. And those that grew up with me know what I'm talking about. I had the misfit skull when I was 16. I got it removed by laser surgery probably about 4 years ago. And not because I didn't like it, but because it was a crappy tattoo. So I got my first when I was 16. I got another Indian on my arm right there when I was 19 that you have seen in some videos that I've since had covered with the new work. I had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I had 6 tattoos before I even started doing YouTube. 4 of them I had removed by laser surgery because they were just crappy tattoos and they were old. I've always wanted to get a sleeve since I was 16. I said, one day I'm going to get a sleeve. And for me, it was just a matter of finding the right person to do the work. I finally found that person that I thought was a great artist, Adam, from Perry Ink Cartel in Hollywood. And he's been doing my sleeve for me. I like it. So it really doesn't matter if you don't like it. Besides, like, You're telling me I might regret it, or you're telling me I'm going to regret it, for those of you that are saying that. Don't you think that that's run through my mind? I mean, I just don't understand the whole mentality. It's my body. I don't look at any of you guys and say, hey, you're going to regret that. If I was, you know, 19, 20, 21, it'd be a different story. I'm 40 years old, okay? I've been around the block. Do I recommend tattoos? Absolutely not. I recommend doing whatever makes you happy. And if it's legal and it's not harming anybody else, go for it. I mean, I don't know how else to explain it. There might come a time where I regret all this. And, you know, that's why there's laser surgery. I could get it lasered off. That's why there's power saws. I can get my arm taken off if I want to, if I want to just do it quick and easy. Oh, and some of you who might say, well, Ed, you believe in the Bible, and in the Bible it says this and it says that. It says, yes, I know the Bible says your body is a temple for God. And, you know, I do believe that to an extent. But hey, no one ever said I was perfect.